buyers and sellers can make decisions based on the direction that we know the market is going in.
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
So how do you see that this is different than things of the past?
Not a real difference, to be honest with you. It's all the same stuff, you know. Something scary happens in the market that people weren't expecting, you know. This time around, the economy was really great. You know, it was just this monster momentum in the economy, and something outside of the economy came in and put a stop to it. So there's always something that happens that catches everybody off guard, scares everybody. You know, that's what creates the fear, is it's like, oh my gosh, that happened? And so what that does is it takes the market and basically puts it on pause for a couple months. Every time we have a crash, there's a scary moment that happened, whether it be 9/11 or the crash that happened in 2008. We had an oil spill down here. We had an oil spill down here in 2010 that was a scary moment for us in our local market. It didn't affect the nation, but it did affect us locally. But that was a scary moment. And so what happens is when these scary moments happen, it puts the market on pause for just a couple months. And everybody wants to kind of take a break, because if you are in the middle of trying to do a transaction, buy or sell a piece of property, and then something scary happens that makes the stock market go down, or you know, makes everybody push the pause button, of course you're not going to go through with the deal, because you don't know, you know, if you're buying something, you don't know if its prices are fixing to go down sharply, or if you're selling something, you don't know what, you know. And on the other side of the couple of month transition, see, now right now we're in a transition period where something scary happened, everybody put the brakes on, and now everybody's waiting to see what's gonna happen, right? It's the same with every crash. The scary moment, pause button for 2 to 4 months to see what's gonna happen, and then at that point, we know what's gonna happen. And so when we come out of this, you know, it doesn't matter if prices drop, it doesn't matter if they go up, or if they continue to be the same, it really doesn't matter. The problem is right now we don't know which way the market's gonna go. That's the unknown part. That's why everybody's waiting around to see. But here in a couple months, we will know which way we're going, and buyers and sellers can make decisions based on the direction that we know the market is going in. Right now, nobody can make a decision because nobody knows. But once we get to that point where we do know which way the market's going to go, and buyers and sellers start making those decisions of how they want to, you know, how they want to buy and sell properties through that new market that we're going to be in, then transactions will go back. You know, it doesn't matter. See, the good thing about it is that price adjusts in our favor. You know, the price is going to move to a price point that buyers will buy. You know, that's the whole point of this. That's the whole point of a market, is supply and demand. So prices are gonna move either up or down or stay the same, but the point is the prices are gonna move to a point where buyers continue to buy. And that's good for real estate agents. You know, that means that people are buying, you know? So people need to sell, people have to sell, people want to sell, people want to do different things and have different ideas and different things going on in their life that cause them to buy and sell properties. And you know, if the prices go down, now we're in more of an investor market. You know, let's find the people that want all these good deals. If the prices stay the same, that means we're in a really balanced market, and we're probably still representing probably half investors, half first-time home buyers. You know, if the market's going up a lot, that means we're probably focused more on mostly maybe first-time home buyers, or people that are in, you know, people are in that kind of market for the most part. So it doesn't matter to us as a broker, as a real estate agent, you know, which way the market's going. What I want you to know is that when we encounter these scary moments, there's always gonna be this 2 to 4 month period of uncertainty, and that's when most agents get out of the business. You know, they're scared, they think it's never gonna come back, you know, but what they should be doing is leaning into the business and making more calls. See, right now, it's even better right now than a normal crash, because a normal crash, you can still leave your house. You know, but right now you can't leave your house, so you really have zero distractions. So you can just sit at the house and make calls all day long. I've been making calls 8 hours a day, which is something I haven't done for years because I'm so busy selling. You know, but I've always said when the market does decide to take a dip, that's going to open my time up to where I can get back what I love to do, making those calls. You know, so I think now is the best time in history to take advantage of the moment that people are sitting at their houses just waiting on people. They're dying to talk to people, you know. And if you're that friendly realtor that's just calling them up to see how they're doing through this and see what you can do to help them now or in the future, you're going to build your database and therefore gobble up market share. Right now is the time to snatch as much market share as you can while most agents are just laying around. You know, using this as an excuse to kind of lay low. So that's the difference between top producers and low producers. You know, the top producers are taking advantage of this moment, and the low producers are using this moment as an excuse.